Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Russian Fishing 4, and today they released a new patch and I'm going to give you guys an overview and my thoughts about the patch. As always, I say my thoughts as I think how the stuff works in the game. So I'm going to discuss with you guys the previous patch too, the blank section of the rods. So I fished now with my rods. For the guys that don't know, you cannot repair anymore the blank. So after some time, if you don't have the pressure or the strength anymore, you need to replace that rod. I was a little bit worried about that system because I thought it was going to wear really quick, but I will give you guys in the second section of this video a little update, because I fish now with two rods, spin fishing, like easily 100 days, so the testing was really good. But that's for the other part of this video. So first of all, what I see in the patch is I think that they are getting a little bit I cannot say scared, but they make it a little bit Steam friendly, I call it, because what I see in the patch is that the prices go up from 22 fish pieces. You got information everywhere, so it's a little bit more friendly to the player base. So I think that's not bad, because I was a little bit worried for the reviews if this comes to Steam, because it's way too hard. I don't see the stock problem. I think that they need to fix the stock problem too before they go to Steam. Otherwise, it's going to be, take it from me, 80% of the new reviews is going to be about the out of stock system in this game. Because I had that problem now too. I'm leveling with the new character and it's very irritating. Because I know what I need to buy to the best possible leveling comparison with silver. And it's very frustrating if I cannot buy that reel, if I cannot buy that rod. Because then I need to adjust and I need to buy something that is not heavy enough. Or something that is not too expensive for me. So it's not so good and I know what I need to do. New players are not going to know that. So back to the patch notes. So first of all, I'm in cottage pond and you got now in the house, you can stock 1,000 items according to the patch. So I'm not sure why that is, because at the moment I don't think, I can be mistaken, but I don't think that inventory in your backpack is limited. So I'm a little bit worried. I don't hope that they are going to do it in the future, because I know another fishing game that they did the same. But at the moment, I cannot find something why they did it. So because at the moment, it's possible that the inventory is limited, but I got 550 items and I don't see a maximum on it. So you can just stock here 1,000 items now in the cottage pond. The cottage pond house is limited. How do you do it? I needed to search a little bit. So you just go to this. You click on this. No, you are not doing this. You need to go to backpack here. Then you click on the bamboo rod. Then you click here on house. Move the item to the house. There you go. And now it's in the house. If you want to move it back, you do just the same. There you go, now it's back in the backpack. You can select more stuff. So if I want to do all those five, I want to put them in the house. Yeah, oh, it's like, oh. Yeah, this takes a little bit of time, it seems. So to put five rods in the house, I hope that I didn't crash. Okay, be aware guys. The garbage bin is very close, so don't misclick. Because if you click on this, I didn't do it already, I will do it a little bit later in my net. Be aware that you are going to discard it. So I'm going to move everything back to my backpack. And there we go again. So that's a very nice feature. Maybe in the future they are going to do something else with it. I'm not sure. So the next stuff I already said to you guys. So player statics now have an exact information. Yeah, that's what I can show you guys. So now you can see in statics the amount of experience that I already got. I already got 27 million experience in this game. And I need almost 5 million to get to the next level. So that's level 34. So it's going to take some time. You can now create, the next one is a really good one. You know now where your position is. That's not bad. I hope in the near future that they are going to put the coordinates on the map too. That will help a lot. So I'm now over here. So here. And I'm watching to here. And that's, yeah, that is right, because I'm watching to the cottage pound house. You guys can see it. So it's really good to see where you are. So that's not bad. The next one, you can make now a chat with global people. So if I go here, I think this is only premium. So if you can create a channel, you can take now here global. So you can talk with guys from other servers, that's the German, that are the Russian, they can join you and you can talk German and Russians with each other. So that's really cool because I know some guys from the German servers, but I cannot play with the guys or not even talk with the guys. And with this new system, you can do that. The same for competitions. If you go for competition, you can just click here and put it now on globally. I think maybe for gold competitions and all that other stuff, if it is not at the same time than the Russian and the German, it's possible that we can make very big gold competitions. Another good feature that I saw is here. So you got now like info. So info, if you go to another menu, you can see. So that's once again a little bit more friendly for the Steam release. For the most people, they're just going to put it off. You just need to click on it and then it's gone. So if you go back now, it's not coming back. This is a very good feature too. You can delete now your fish in your net. So for a guy that trolls a lot like me, sometimes by accident, I keep fish and I think I'm going to sell it. But at very good days, your net can be filled really quick. Now, check this. I got a perch here of 62 gram. You can just click on it, garbage bin. You need to take this. Ah, that's good that they always ask for a confirmation. And now it's gone. In the past, I needed to go to with my boat to the dock. I needed to sell. Then I needed to start trolling again. But on very good days, it's sometimes a little bit problematic because you think, oh, well, yeah, I'm going to miss a fish. So now you can. That's a very good feature. I like it a lot because I already got a couple of times that I think by myself, yeah. I want to keep fishing, but I need to go selling. So, and you cannot make every fish in like fish pieces. Okay, the next one. Yeah, the competitions I got. Optimization of the game during the nighttime play. I'm not sure what they mean with it, so don't have a clue to be honest. So I will to have to check it what that is. Then the price of 22 species went up. They raised it by 5 to 30%, so the 30% is really good, but I don't know what is 30%. So white eye bream, I see dace, silver bream, white bream, bleak, ruff, gudgeon, Chinese sleeper, Arctic char, Kyura char, Atlantic salmon, asp, Severn trout, char, burbot, zander, grayling, lake trout, pike, chub, volgazander, and perch. So 5 to 30%. I think that was a little bit needed too, so that's not bad. I'm always happy if I can make more silver. Maximum weight of some species of Winding Rivulet has been raised. I'm not sure that's a really good plan because Winding Rivulet is that level 8? I cannot say it, but I think it's level 8. So at level 8, yeah, most of the time in my leveling guide, I had at level 8, I had two telescopics and one feeder rod. So yeah, to give it a little bit more attraction, Winding Rivulet to the maybe the higher levels, it's not a bad plan, but I think for the leveling guys it's not a good plan. I'm not sure how big the fish are because it's always a little bit yeah, cryptical what they are saying. So yeah, description to some skills have been updated, so you can now see a little bit better what the skills do. And fixed feeder that have been in player's position prior to the last patch didn't get updated. Okay, that's the feeders. What do they mean with it? The last patch we had feeders, and you now you can only get like one ground bait in it. But then it went to two. I'm not sure it went to three, and I think that was bugged. Some places of Winding Rivulet didn't have current. Oh, yeah, that's a pity. So they fixed it now. So a lot of players were so happy that we didn't have current anymore in Winding Rivulet. I was happy too, because to be honest, that current was so irritating. So it was a bug. So everybody was now fishing in Winding Rivulet because there wasn't a current anymore. But the current is back, guys. So fixed records didn't show up in chat. That's really cool. So we can see the records again. So it's not a bad patch. It's a little bit more friendly. There are a lot of stuff that I like. The upgrade in silver is good. that you can discard stuff in your net. That's very good. Yeah, that's it a little bit for me, I think. Yeah, the position is really good too. I hope the coordinates are coming. So now it's time to show you guys a little bit the blank. So I fished with my black edition and I fished with my duty. I fished, I can say 100 hours. I'm not sure how much it is, but I think I fish around, let's say, 4 or 5 hours every day. And I think the previous patch was 2 or 3 weeks ago. So it's going to be very close to 100 hours. So I was a little bit worried about this system because I was thinking I don't like that system because what they are saying, they can say what you want, but at some point they are just saying, yeah, at some point you need to replace your rod. I don't think that's a problem if you got very cheap rods, because with very cheap rods in this game you are not going to catch more fish because you got very expensive rod. That's the main problem. So that was always the problem in this game. I can understand if I buy this for 6,000 and I catch 50% more fish and I make 50% more money than other people, that I can understand that. But that's not the case. I got days I can do what I want with this rod. I got days that I catch nothing, just the same like a guy with a Super Duty. So I was a little bit worried. But I said to myself, KP, be a little bit calm, stay, think a little bit and just test it. And I need to say, after some testing, I fished 100 hours, I got 0.2% wear. That's all. So I can fish with this rod until it hits the 10% damage, I think easily 1000 hours. So I think the system, yeah, it's, how can I say it? I think that the practical side of the system is not bad, but I don't like the system. Because I want to keep my rod. At some point I need to say, and you can say, yeah, you can use it for other stuff. No. I want, this is my rod, I paid for this rod, and I want to keep it until the end, and I want to repair it that I can keep using. There is some emotional value at gear too. It seems really crazy, but I got on this fish my 13 kg Savant trout. And I know there is a day that is coming that I need to say to this, okay, yeah, I cannot fish anymore with you because I'm going to break you if I keep fishing with you. Or if I buy something with this, with gold, at some point I know, yeah, that gold value is gone. So therefore, the system, I don't like it, but the practical side is good. There is almost no wear on it. My Super Duty, that is lower quality, just the same, 0.2. So I got the same damage on both of them. So, and that's after 100-hour fishing. So the practical side is not bad. So that was it a little bit, guys. My thoughts about the new patch and my thoughts about the blanks. So some nice stuff. Yeah, I cannot say more, guys. Thanks for watching. Have fun in Russian Fishing 4. And I see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.